Good morning, students. How are you all? Hope all are fine. Now we are going to see chapter 5, adjectives. Standard 5, chapter 5, adjectives. Let us see point A. Adjective. It is a word that describes or qualifies a noun or pronoun. They made a bouquet of pink and white flowers. The old lady offered a silent prayer. He is quite busy. Two bluebirds sat on this tall tree. These are adjectives. Okay, these are adjectives. Let us know about the kinds of adjectives. Adjectives of quality and descriptive adjectives. Read the following examples. The dog is a faithful animal. The blind man wanted to cross the road. Anjali wore a pretty dress. The red car met with an accident. So, faithful, blind, pretty, beautiful, red, nice, or noisy. These are the adjectives, okay? Descriptive adjectives. The underlined words describes the A dog, B man, C dress, and D car. Therefore, the word that describes a person, animal, or place or thing is called an adjective of quality and descriptive adjective. Adjective of quantity. Okay, now quantity, how it will come? Here may come number or amount. Okay, read the following examples. Some men are very strong. Most people think they are clever. The sage is a man of few words. A day comes when all men and women must die. Okay, it is a countable, okay, quantity. The underlined words tells us how much or how many persons or things are there. Such types of words that tell us the number of person, animal, or thing are called adjectives of quantity. Adjective of number or numeral adjectives. Read the following examples. The demon had two sharp horns. Okay, these are the countables. Okay, counting, how or we can count. Okay, so the countable numbers, okay, or the countable measurement, that will come in numeral adjectives. A flat is on the first floor. Three uncles of mine have become doctors. The man had 4 degrees, but eight had no job. The underlined words tells us the quantity about the noun spoken of. Hence, they are called adjectives of number or numeral adjectives. Numeral adjectives are of two types, definite numerals and indefinite numerals. Definite numerals, that is 1, 2, 5, etc. And first, thrice, fourth, penta, okay. So, these are called definite numbers. Indefinite numbers, some, few, any, none, many, several, etc. Now, distributive adjectives. Read the following examples. Every student should bring rupees 500 for the picnic. The book belongs to neither you nor me. Each town of the state is populated. Either you or I will finish the first in the race. So, these are distributive, okay? Either you or me. Demonstrative adjectives. Read the following examples. That boy has lost his purse. This carpet has magical properties. Such accidents are common. These mangoes are very sweet. These, those, such, okay? These are demonstrative adjectives. The word that this, such, and these point it to a particular person, animal, place, or thing. Such words are called demonstrative adjectives. Interrogative adjectives. Now here it will come with the WH question. Words, the words what, which, whose, used with nouns to ask questions about nouns are called interrogative adjectives. What dress are you wearing tonight? Okay, WH questions. Which country has the largest population? Whose cricket bat is this? Possessive adjectives. My, your, his, her, are, their, and its are possessive adjectives shows to whom the person or thing belongs. My mother asked me to help her in the kitchen. We stand with our arms by our sides for a national anthem. A school has its own football team. Now here there is an exercise, okay? Underline the adjectives and state their kind, whether they are adjective of quantity, adjective of quality, or numeral adjectives. Okay, I am going to buy a few cows, so few will come in adjective of quantity. He picked up a stout stick that stood in a corner. Stood is a verb. Okay, adjective of quality. The sky grew dark in a moment. Dark, adjective of quality. Next, I have to drive away your greedy cows. Your, possessive adjective. Greedy, adjective of quality. Germany had defeated several teams to enter the final against the Indian team. Several, adjective of quantity. Indian, adjective of quality. Now, dear students, we have already seen 5 examples. Rest all I am leaving for you as a homework. Now, let us go for the degrees of comparison of adjectives. Okay, read the following sentences. Shankar is a strong man. Madhav is stronger than Shankar. Vishnu Prasad is the strongest of all. Okay, now this is a positive sentence, comparative sentence, and superlative degree. Okay, superlative sentence. So in the first sentence, the word strong states the quality of Shankar as a man. In the second sentence, there is a comparison between two persons, where the quality of Madhav is better than the quality of Shankar, of a higher degree. In the third statement, comparison is made among three person, in which the quality of Vishnu Prasad is the best of all and is of the highest degree. Next, hence every adjective of quality has 3 degrees. Okay, positive degree when we speak of only one person or thing. Comparative degree when we compare two persons or things. Superlative degree when we compare 3 or more persons or things, and one of them is having the highest degree. Okay, now positive, comparative, and superlative degree. Okay, positive with 1, comparative with 2, and superlative 3 and more. Positive, strong, comparative, stronger, superlative, strongest. Okay, now formation of the comparative and superlative degree of adjectives. Most adjectives form their comparative by ending er, okay, er, and the superlative by adding est to the positive degree. Now positive word is given, we have to change it in comparative and superlative. Bold, bolder, boldest. Sweet, sweeter, sweetest. Clean, cleaner, cleanest. Clever, cleverer, cleverest. Okay, these are the things which they have given. Now let us move to the next. When the positive degree ends with the vowel, there only r is added for the comparative and st for the superlative. Brave, braver, bravest. Wise, wiser, wisest. Noble, nobler, noblest. Safe, safer, safest. Large, larger, largest. When the positive degree ends in y preceded by a constant, the y is changing to ier for the comparative and ies for the superlative. Tiny, tinier, tiniest. Funny, funnier, funniest. Easy, easier, easiest. Happy, happier, happiest. Lazy, lazier, laziest. Next, in some words, the last letter is doubled or er is added for the comparative and est for the superlative. Sad, sadder, saddest. Hot, hotter, hottest. Big, bigger, biggest. Fat, fatter, fattest. Thin, thinner, thinnest. Words which have 2 syllables form the comparative by adding more before them and the superlative by adding most before them. ब्यूटिफुल मोर ब्यूटिफुल मोस्ट ब्यूटिफुल केयरलेस मोर केयरलेस मोस्ट केयरलेस इम्पोर्टेंट मोर इम्पोर्टेंट मोस्ट इम्पोर्टेंट इंटरेस्टिंग मोर इंटरेस्टिंग मोस्ट इंटरेस्टिंग एक्टिव मोर एक्टिव मोस्ट एक्टिव ओके नाउ दीज आर द थिंग्स विच दे हैव टोल्ड अस बिफोर ESTIER more most okay positive comparative and superlative some commonly used adjectives from their comparative and superlative is an irregular way good well or better best bad ill worse best much many more most old older elder older oldest eldest far further furthest late later latter latest last up upper uppermost little less least okay here there are now exercise identify the degree of the adjective in the following sentence an orange is juicier than an apple comparative degree june is as hot as july positive australia is largest island in the world superlative degree few actresses are as pretty as sonali positive degree The Nile is the longest river, superlative degree. Use words from the brackets and fill in the blank. Rani is tall, but her sister is taller than her. Ratan has big house, but Kate's house is bigger than his house. Strawberries are sweet, but bananas are sweeter than strawberries. A coconut tree is taller than a mango tree. Okay, students, now we have seen the degrees. Okay, we have seen the degrees. Let us read the... lesson and know what are the degrees and adjectives okay degrees and adjective thank you